I'd like to start with an exercise. I would ask everybody to be silent for 30 seconds and listen to this place. The next thing I would like you to do is to take a breath and then take a second breath and then in your heart thank the ocean for the second breath.
The ocean is important because everything on the planet depends on the ocean. Without an ocean, this planet would not be habitable. It had a surface temperature of maybe 200 degrees, more like Venus. There would be no water that sustains life. There would be much less food, particularly some of the micronutrients we need for brain development, and it provides half of the oxygen we breathe. So every life function that you can think of depends on the ocean, not in an abstract way, but in a very real day-to-day way. We don't think about that on a day-to-day basis because we don't see it. So my job is to make that visible and also make people feel what that's like. On land, I think we've evolved to be like a teenager. We know some things, we feel we own the world, really we're a little bit naive, but we're kind of romping around doing stuff. In the ocean, we're more like a toddler. So we grab something, we put it in our mouth, that doesn't taste so good, we try something else. We're like that, you know, we're very much just kind of like in the dark, trying to figure out how this place works. That's why it's so difficult for us. It's just that we don't know very much. We invent plastic and it's a wonderful thing and we use it on land and we are kind of neglecting that half of it washes into the ocean and pollutes the ocean and clogs up the ocean and it stays in the ocean because it doesn't break down. It's one of the side effects that we didn't think about when we were inventing this material. So this is something we need to fix. The good news story is that we've learned how to correct our mistakes. In many cases, we have been able to correct them before it was too late. For example, in saving the whales. Whales were on their way out. We made a collective decision as a people, not just in Canada, but around the world, to save the whales. And it was done, and whales are recovering. So that really gives me hope that this can be done, and something emerges in this group that's much more than any one of us could provide. And to me, that was probably the most moving aspect of this experience. It's not about individuals, it's about what we can do as a group.